Good morning, children. Welcome. Welcome back to the accountancy class. Verse. The Lord is faithful to all his promises and loving toward all he has made. We are his creation. He loves us. His words are faithful. Trust him. Trust him and talk to him every day. Okay, children, with that note, we are going to move into today's lesson. We are going to continue subsidiary books 1. Last week we studied purchases and purchase returns. Today we'll see sales and sales returns.
What did we study in the last class?
We studied the subsidiary books, the main books.
That is, purchases, purchase returns book,
sales, sales returns book,
cash book, journal proper,
bills receivable and bills payable book.
And we studied in detail about purchases book and purchase returns book.
What is the purpose of purchases book?
To record all the credit purchases.
For purchases returns?
To record all the purchases returns.
Can we recall the format of purchase book?
Yes. Date, particulars, invoice number, LF, amount and amount.
Why should we have two amount columns?
One for showing the calculation, that is, the calculation will be shown in the inner column,
and the final amount in the outer column. Oh, is that so?
Okay, time to go to today's class.
Let's go.
Okay, right. Sales book. Sales book is a subsidiary book maintained to record credit sale of goods, cash sale of goods and sale of property and assets, whether for cash or on credit, are not recorded in the sales book. This book is also named as sales day book, sold day book, sales journal or sale register. So you have to remember three things when you're preparing your sales book. Okay. Number one, sales book records only credit sales. So number two, sales book will not record any cash transaction. Sales book will not record any sale of asset. Right, these are the three things you will remember when you are preparing your sales book. The last one is the other name for sales book, sold day book, sales journal or sale register. Now this is a format of your sales book. I hope you remember the format of your purchases book. Okay, same. Date, when the transaction took place, name of the customer to whom we have sold, what are the discounts allowed. Okay, so how much he has to pay, LF, that is the ledger folio, invoice number, amount and amount. Here it is given as details and total. We can just have it as amount and amount. Okay, right. See this problem. From the transactions given below, prepare the sales book of Kumar Stationery for July 2017. Sold on credit to Saravana Traders of Sayalgudi. It is a credit transaction, it will take place. Sold to Raja for cash. Will you enter this? Sold to Raja for cash? No, because it is a cash transaction. Sold to Mohan and Co. of Mudukulathur. Credit transaction, it will take place. Sold on credit to Narayanan. Old motor car asset. Will this transaction take place in your sales book? No, so this will not come. Sold to Kumaran for cash, 15 packets of marker pens. Since it is a cash transaction, even this will not come in your sales book. You're able to understand? So just see the sales book. What is more important? The format is very important, children, right? Heading, in the books of Kumar Stationery, sales book. It is not account, it is book. So only one side of your notebook has to be used. Date, particulars, invoice number, LF, amount and amount, right? 5-7-2017 from Saravana Traders. What all he has bought? 10 packs of A4 sheets, the rate of rupees 250 per bag, per pack, so it is 2500. 10 dozens writing pads, the rate of rupees 850 per dozen, 8500. Add this, 2500 plus 8500 is 11000. Less 10% trade discount is 1100. Outer column shows 9900. Clear? Next one. Mohan and Co. Mudukulathur. 5 white boards, the rate of rupees 2200 each. So it is 11000. 10 dozens of writing pads, the rate of rupees 850 per dozen. That is 8500. Here we don't have any discount. So just you add this and take it to the outer column. That is 19,500. What is the total? 29,400. That has to be transferred to sales account creditor. Clear? Okay. Ledger accounts. Sales account. Always sales account shows a credit balance. So buy sundry debtors 29,400. The total of your sales book. Saravana Traders account. 2 sales account 9,900. One more, Mohan and Co. account. 2 sales account 19,500. Can you see? In all the ledger accounts, I did not balance the account. Post it, leave it. No need to balance your ledger accounts in subsidiary books. Clear? Sales returns book. Goods returned by the customer is known as returns inwards. This book is not concerned with the return of assets or return of goods for which cash is paid. This book is prepared just like the other day books. So sales returns book records what the debtors, the customers have returned back. Okay. Now, what are the reasons for them to return back? Any defect in the goods? Delay in the dispatch of goods to the customer, oversupply of goods, goods not being in accordance with the samples and specification, violation of the terms of the contract, etc. Now, these are the reasons why the customers are returning the goods back to the seller. Okay. This is the format of your sales returns book. Can you see? Date, name of the supplier, then LF, credit note. Here it is not invoice number, it is credit note, amount and amount. Okay, date, name of the supplier, LF, credit note, and then amount, amount. Okay, children. Enter the following transactions and returns inward book of Mahesh, a textile dealer. We have 3. Returned by Shankar, 30 shirts each costing rupees 150. What is the reason? Inferior quality. Amar Tailors returned 10 t-shirts each costing rupees 100 on account of being not in accordance with their order. Prema Stores returned 12 salwar sets each costing rupees 200 being not in accordance with the order. Okay. How to prepare your account? In the books of Mahesh Textile Dealer, sales returns book. In your date column, what you have to write? Date. Particulars, the name of the person and what, how much is returning and what is the rate. Okay. Credit note number. If your problem specifies the credit note number, you write it here. Otherwise, leave it blank. Then LF, amount and amount. Clear? First one, Shankar is returning 30 shirts at the rate of rupees 150. So 30 into 150 is 4,500. Amar Tailors, 10 t-shirts at the rate of rupees 100. So 10 into 100 is 1000. Prema Stores, 12 salwar sets at the rate of rupees 200. So 12 into 200 is 2400. Add all the amount which is in the inner column and give it in the outer column, that is 7900. That is the total of your sales returns book. Is that clear, children? You are able to understand? Let's see the ledger accounts. Sales returns account. The total of your sales returns book. Two sundry debtors account, 7,900. Shankar account, buy sales returns account, 4,500. Amar Taylor's account, buy sales returns account, 1,000. And Prema Stores, buy sales returns account, 2,400. Postage, no need to balance, just leave it. Right? Now see this problem. Prepare necessary subsidiary books in the books of Niranjan and also Sachin account and Mukil account for the following transactions for the month of February 2017. If you can see, you have purchases, you have sales, you have purchase returns, you have sales returns. So you have to prepare four books. Purchase book, purchase returns book, sales returns book. Along with that, they have asked you to prepare two accounts. Sachin account and Mukil account. That is your ledger accounts of Sachin and ledger accounts of Mukil. Clear, children? Right, let's see the problem. See, purchases, purchase book. Purchase from Mukil Traders, 12,480. Again from Mukil Traders, 15,200. So the total of the purchases book for the month of February, 27,680. Right. You also have purchases returns. You have returned goods to Mukil Traders. So Mukil Traders, the amount is 1,500. Right. The next one is sales book. From Sachin, 15,000. From Manish Traders, 12,100. From Manish and Co., 13,300. The total of the sales book for the month of February, that is the credit sales, is 40,400. See, so your sales returns book, you have returned goods. Sachin Traders have returned goods. So 1,200 is the total sales returns for the month of February, right? Now, you have to do your ledger accounts. Mukil Traders account. Buy purchases and buy purchases, 12,480 and 15,200. But you also have purchases returns, right? You purchased, you have returned. So now you have to balance your account. When you balance your account, your balance will be 26,180, your normal ledger balance. Clear? The next one is Sachin account. See, you have sales, you also have sales returns. So you have to balance the Sachin account. So two sales, 15,000. Buy sales returns account, 1,200. If you can balance the account, it is 13,800. Write the total on both the sides. When you have a closing balance, you should also have a opening balance. That is all. Okay. Now this is your homework problem. Problem number 5 to 7 is your homework. Do it in your accountancy notebook. Right. Please work out your problems so that it will help you in future. Okay, children. Okay. Take care and stay safe. God bless you.